In the 50s, I sang with Tito Puente's orchestra. And his most powerful congoist was a renowned Mongo Santa Maria. And Mongo taught me a song. And when I tried to hold the time like that, he said, "No, baby, I said, you can't do it that way. You can't hold the time. You must hold it with your feet." He said, "This is a religious song." So I asked him, "What does it mean?" Because I speak Spanish. And he said that he didn't know, but his mother used the song in ritual, and she taught all the children to sing it. So I learned the song. And then years later, I was living in Egypt, and my next door neighbor was a very elegant Nigerian lady who wore bibs of gold, and she would come next door to me, and we'd have coffee together, and she was so grand. And one day she said to me, "Sister, you speak so many languages, but only one African language, which was Xhosa, the South African language." I said, "Well, you know, I learned a song. I don't know what it means, but I think it is African. I'd like to sing it." So I sang it to her. And when I looked up, her face was bathed in tears. This elegant, sophisticated woman. She said, "Sister, it's old Yoruba. It's a slave song. And it says, Father, Father, they have taken me from you over water so wide, and they treat me worse than a dog in your compound. Father, can you, your magic, find me and bring me home?" Baba fururu ere re o, omo kanyene ele yugo, ele rifumbati waso, ele gore re bati mwao, emno anye ya wao, eya kwaluru. Centuries of voices have rumbled down the years. Voices stacked upon voices, close as accordion piece. Voices telling and relating and retelling, informing the horrors of the stories of their lives. They say, "Father, they have taken me across waters wider than the world, wetter than my tears. I received treatments worse than the lowest dog in your backyard. Father, Father, can you hear me?" Voices pleading, calling, begging, "Hear me. Someone speak to me. Speak of me. Speak for me." The voices shout in languages as various as Yoruba, Kru, Fanti, Hausa. A fierce urgency forces the sound out and upon the air and into the ears of courageous men, of brave women who respond. They say, "I hear you, and I will speak to you. I will speak of you. I will speak for you. I will be joined by numerous other voices who also hear your calling. We will send our own voices to the land, into the offices of industries, and into the minds hardened against you and your children. They will be persuaded to look upon your faces with favor and upon your future with promise. We hear you calling. We hear you. We begin by giving you 100 years of loving defense. We shall encourage the world to look upon your complexion and see community. We have lopped off the branches which held your swaying bodies, and we love you. Where you have been made idle, we shall search and find work for you, which will compensate your efforts and define your worth. Our voices shall march up and down the cotton rows, in and out of sharecroppers' cabins, and onto the mean streets of ghettos. We shall listen to you, and for your sake, we will enter the wasteland where the twin horrors of hate and violence abide. We would offer our hands of friendship, and along with a climate, which means to soothe the angry heart and calm the bellicose spirit. We have stretched our hands across 10 scores of years to pull your name from the forgotten roster. We will wipe your tears with the palms of our hands. We listen and we will continue to listen. We shall continue to speak for you. You will not be abandoned. You will not be forgotten. We will call your name loudly, loudly, our people. And you may call us the Urban League. Thank you.